So, ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to the show. It is Yap with yours truly, Omara Daniel. Alone today, very sad, very miserable, because my co-host, as you can see, is visibly absent. The reason is because Christmas, you know, food and stuff. Apparently, he came down with a stomach bug. That's a polite way of saying he has dios, but we're not going to dwell too much on it. I know exactly what the problem is. It's that Christmas food people have been eating. So pray for Tumusime and also get this man a dietitian. You can't keep eating like this and think it's going to be okay. But welcome. It's me, Omara Daniel, on a solo plot today. The show is Yap. And if you want to find me online, it's Omara Daniel OL, the LOL model on Twitter and Instagram. And on Facebook, Omara D. The Baganda know what I mean. Wink, wink. So let's get into the news today, ladies and gentlemen. It's the festive season, of course. And speaking of dios, we're going to be talking about this Christmas food you guys have been eating, because after Tumusime's predicament, I felt the need to address it. Oh my God, who wrote these lower thirds? Goodness. Okay, who put the word diarrhea and Christmas in the same? It's Jesus' birthday, for Christ's sake. Okay, for his sake. But yeah, let's go on. So it turns out people have been eating quite a bit, which is the natural order of things. It's the festive season. There's supposed to be an abundance of food. That is if you don't have village people visiting you. Personally, I'm not a fan of village people visiting for Christmas. They eat a lot more. Before you judge me, let me explain. Now, people in the village assume city life is easy because there's flowing water, there's electricity, there's all these amazing things. People in the city think village life is easier because, you know, it's a subsistence economy. Basically, you grow your food and you eat it. So there's a void, there's a gap in between with us understanding each other, which means we mess up when we go to see each other, especially if you don't bring presents. The point I'm trying to make is there's a lot of eating involved in this season, and people have been eating tremendously, which should be a good thing. I mean, Uganda is not one of those countries dealing with obesity at a high level, but guys, the point, what I'm trying to say is be careful. Be careful how you eat during the festive season, because this stuff comes back to catch up with you eventually. A lot of you out here finishing everything on the table, which is good. If you can afford it, I mean, why not eat it? But can you look after yourselves as you eat this food? Because doctors are saying the most unhealthy eating happens during the festive season. I'm going to give you a few examples of stuff you guys don't know. You can't have a meal where everything is fried. That, there's no way that can be healthy. Those are way too many calories. I mean, your heart is lodging a complaint with the guys upstairs. Your heart is basically reporting to HR and telling them, yo, I am being mistreated in my own establishment. Another thing, sodas. Guys, the limit is like one soda. One soda is enough. We don't understand why you have to do five sodas on Christmas Day. What are you trying to prove? You're a human being, not a bee. I mean, there's lots of other things you can live off on. Even Jesus said, man shall not live on soda alone. So try not to kill yourself in the process of trying to enjoy yourself. I know a lot of you have put your resolution, oh, New Year's first of 2021, I'm going to the gym. If it's open, and also if you're sober and not hungover, then maybe you will. But the more realistic option would be to take care of yourself. Eat wisely. As you consume, we're trying to make sure. The plan is to make it into the new year, okay? So be safe as you eat. Don't be like Tumusime. Now, this is an interesting story that I think we need to address. And this one, this next story, especially, is dedicated to all the youth of Uganda. A man of 25 years sold his kidney to buy an iPad. Seems like a normal thing, right? It's something dumb a human being would do. But here's the twist in the story, because that's not where it ends. God has a sense of humor. And I'm not saying we should be laughing, but I think we are going to. Here's what happens. He sold his kidney to buy an iPad, and now he's bedridden for life because his other kidney failed. Now, for those of you who don't know what an iPad is, it's that small flat device made by Apple that everybody wants, you know, that one, as you can see on the screen. And this guy had to be Chinese. Wang Shangkung, or northerner, 25 years old, was so desperate for Apple's flagship iPod and iPad devices, he decided to sell his kidney in 2011 on the black market in East China. He sold his kidney for like an iPod, for an iPad 2 or something like the first model of iPad back in the day. And now, sadly, 9 years later, his other kidney has failed and he's bedridden for life. For those of you who don't know what a kidney is, producer, you will help me and put it on the screen. I think people often confuse it with another body part. I mean, in the males, they're also connected to the testicles. It's right down there under the, like your lower back. It's connected to the balls. So for those of you, when your kidneys hurt, when you have blue balls, just know they're sharing the pain with each other. Thank you. Those are the kidneys. Very important organs. They're basically in charge of filtration. They're the National Water Corporation of your body. They're very important. And this guy sold one for an iPad. Now, guys, I don't want to sound judgmental or anything, but we have to put this out there. This was dumb. This was dumb. And I promised not to laugh, but I didn't promise not to sound judgmental. The reality is, this is up there on the list of dumb things you can do. This is right up there with thinking Firefly is the opposite of Waterfall. This is up there with Bebe Cool. This is so high up on the list of dumb things you could do in your life that it's just impossible to fathom. People, let's be serious about our lives, for example. Fine, I know it's Chinese. There's a lot of them. One of them dying really wouldn't make a difference to the economy. But I don't understand at what point in our lives our physical health became more important than items like this. The irony is, you're going to give away your kidney that could have given you an entire life for a device that's going to be outdated in a year's time. These are the things you have to remember. There'll be a better version next year. How many kidneys do you have? That means you can only afford two devices, but you only have one life. So take care of yourselves. I'm saying this because I know a lot of you are out there giving away more valuable things for the things, for vanity, for the things that you think are actually more important in your life. They are not. People are selling Gucci to buy iPhones. People are giving away their dignity, their sanity, compromising on their morality to have the things that we call the finer things in life, something that will be outdated in a year's time. The moral of the story is, don't be stupid, please. Maybe I'm harsh. Maybe I sound harsh in the way I'm saying it. But if my son did this, I'll take his liver as well. Because clearly he doesn't deserve these organs if he's willing to give them away that easily. In fact, I'll take his brain because he's not using it. So in your pursuit of happiness, plan, be realistic, set goals, do things right, plot for yourself. Because I swear, if I had an option to sell like one testicle for the things I wanted in life, I would have by now. There's two of them. I don't mind giving birth to only one gender of children, but at the end of the day, I will regret it sometime. So don't do stupid things that you're going to regret. Ladies and gentlemen, as we go for the break, I want you to ponder on that. And after this, we'll be back with a very interesting story about how the journalist shot UPDF, apparently. I'm Daniel O'Mara. I'll see you after the break. Keep it urban. It's time.